Hare Rama, Hare Rama, भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय We're reading Bhagavad Gita. Chapter 4. Text number 18. Karmaniya karma yapashyat akarmani cha karmaya sabudhiman manusheshu sayukta krishna karma krit karmaniya karma yapashyat Akarmani chakarmaya Sabudhiman manusheshu Sayukta krishna karma krit Karmani akarmaya pashyat Akarmani chakarmaya Sabudhiman manusheshu Sayukta krishna karma krit Solution Kanchan
Karmaniya karmaya pashyat
Karmani in action. Akarma in action. Yeah. One who Pashyat observes. Akarmani in action. Cha also karma, fruit of action. Yeah, one food. Cha he. Buddhiman is intelligent. Manushyeshu in human society. Sa he yukta is in the transcendental position. Krishna karma krit, although engaged in all activities. Translation: one who sees inaction in action and action in inaction is intelligent among men, and he is in the transcendental position, although engaged in all sorts of activities.
于活动中见不活动，于不活动中见活动，这样的人才是人中之智者。 虽然他也从事种种活动，却已达超然境界。
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. A person acting in Krishna consciousness is naturally free from the bonds of karma. His activities are all performed for Krishna. Therefore, he does not enjoy or suffer any of the effects of work. Consequently, he is intelligent in human society, even though he is engaged in all sorts of activities for Krishna. Akarma means without reaction to work. The impersonalist ceases fruitive activities out of fear, so that the resultant action may not be a stumbling block on the path of self-realization. But the personalist knows rightly his position as the eternal servitor of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, he engages himself in the activities of Krishna consciousness. Because everything is done for Krishna, he enjoys only transcendental happiness in the discharge of this service. Those who are engaged in this process are known to be without desire for personal sense gratification. The sense of eternal servitorship to Krishna makes one immune to all sorts of reactionary elements of work.
Om
Jnana Tivarandasya Jnananjana Shalataya Tatsurmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovistam Stapidam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sahrajatam Sahagana Radhanatam Vitam Tam Sajevam Sadvaitam Savadukam Arjuna Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamscha He Krishna Karana Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Tapta Kanchana Gaurange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupata Rukyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namah Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Nahane Namaste Sarasati Deve Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschachate Shatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Lord Krishna is describing what is the difference between action and inaction. And here he is describing, if one can understand action and inaction, then he is intelligent among men and he is in the transcendental position. And that person may be engaged in all kinds of activities, but he remains in the transcendental position. So people often think transcendental position means to stop all activities. Srila Prabhupada describes how the impersonalists stop activities out of fear. They're afraid that there will be reactions from their activities. And this will prevent them from achieving the transcendental platform. But in contrast, those who are devotees, those who understand the Lord, the Supreme Lord as a person, they will engage in all kinds of activities for the pleasure of the Lord. So we have to understand the difference between action and inaction. And here in this verse, Lord Krishna compares inaction and action. He says that actually somebody may think they're inactive, but there will be actions resulting from their position. Just like we said, the impersonalists, they're trying to achieve transcendence. And they're afraid of getting reactions from their work. So they often go away from the world. Sometimes they will take a vow of silence. What we call mona vrat. They vow not to speak for some time. It's interesting if you meet people doing mona vrat that they often don't speak, but they carry a little blackboard with them with a piece of chalk and they write everything on the blackboard.
挺有意思的,如果你遇到了一些遵守mona vrat的人,他们是不讲话,可是他们随时携带一块小黑板,还拿着一支粉笔。
I was in India one time and we were traveling in a remote area and there was this temple we could see on a hillside. There was a temple and we thought, let's go and see if anybody's there in the temple.
有一次我在旅行，是在很偏僻的地方，然后我们看到山上有一座庙，于是我们就说，咱们看看那个庙里有没有人。
We were engaged in distributing Prabhupada's books, so we had some books with us. So we thought, let's take a few books with us. Maybe we can distribute the book there.
我们当时是在努力的派书，所以就想着，要不然咱们带几本书去看看，在那是不是有可能带几本书。
And we got up the hill, went into the temple, and there was a sadhu there.
我们上山进到庙里，发现里面有一位沙杜。
But he went.
他说要闭着嘴摇手。
Right, he just covered his mouth and shook his hand, indicating was not going to speak to us.
他就这样的闭捂着嘴，然后摇着手，意思就是在表明他不会跟我们讲话的。
So he wasn't going to speak, but he couldn't avoid hearing us.
他不想跟我们讲话，但是无法避免听我们说话。
So we spoke to him and we told him, you know, we're from England and we're distributing these books today. We brought this Bhagavad Gita.
我们就告诉他，我们来自于英国，我们今天带了巴格瓦蒂卡，我们在派书。
And we're distributing this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita everywhere. And because you're living here in this temple, you know, you should have this Bhagavad Gita.
我们在所有的地方派发巴格瓦蒂卡的知识，你呢住在这个庙里，你也应该请一本巴格瓦蒂卡。
So he took his chalk and he wrote on the board, how much is it?
他于是拿出了本笔。
And he bought a book. So, you know, people try to be, they try to avoid activities, but, you know, they cannot, you cannot stop certain activities. You know, you still have to breathe, you still have to, eat a little bit, or drink a little bit.
你没有办法去避免，就所有的都避免。你得吃点东西，你得喝点水，你也不能停止你的呼吸。
You move around. Sometimes you step on something, maybe even an insect by mistake.
你还是要走路，然后你走一点点路的话，可能有时候会犯错，踩到一只昆虫。
So even though somebody is trying to practice in action, still there will be some actions.
即使有人想努力的休息不活动，但仍然还是会有一些活动。
But Lord Krishna talks about a person who is engaged in Krishna consciousness, and he describes how they are active.
主慧生描述一个在 Krishna 知觉之中的人，他是怎么活动的？
He said there.The devotee is a case of action in inaction.
他说不见者是在不活动之中见活动。
He is engaged in activities, but all of his activities are dedicated for the pleasure of Krishna.
他从事各种各样的活动，但他所有的活动都是为了能够取悦慧师。
So he doesn't get any reactions from his activities.
因此他不会从他的活动之中得到任何的报应。
The devotee is engaged in all kinds of activities for the pleasure of Krishna.
一个奉献者为了取悦 Krishna 而从事于各种各样的活动。
But he's not going to get any karma.
但是他不会得到任何 karma.
Because all of his acts are dedicated for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord.
因为他所有的活动都是为了献给至尊主。
So this was important because Arjuna was worried about the sinful reactions which would come on him for taking part in a battle.
这是很重要的，因为阿朱呢是担心他由于做就是参与打仗，然后他就产生一些很不好的反应。
But Lord Krishna is explaining that if he performs his activities as karma yoga, then there is no reaction from that.
但主跟神向他解释说，如果你把所有的一切都当做他们多个来做的话，那你去履行这些活动也不会有任何的反应。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes that yajnardat karmananyantra loko yam karma bandhana.Tad artam karma kuntiya mukta sangha samacharam. That work done as a sacrifice for Vishnu has to be performed.
在八佛地的这中 ，Krishna 提到，为了取悦 Krishna， 为了取悦主 Vishnu 的祭祀必须要举行。
And if it's not performed as a sacrifice for Vishnu.Then it's material activities and it binds one to the material world.
如果不是为了取悦主为什么而去做一个祭祀的话，那这种祭祀会把一个人束缚在物质世界之中。
So Lord Krishna encouraged Arjuna that he should perform his activities for the pleasure of the Lord, and in this way remain always unattached and free from bondage.
于是主为什么他鼓励阿朱呢？努力地去实现主的愿望去活动，然后这样他可以免于所有的活动的束缚。
Karmic activities are there for everything we do if it's not done in the service of the Supreme.
如果我们做活动的话，不是为了服务尊主，那么我们做的所有的一切的活动都会有业报的反应。
We have to understand there are different kinds of work.
我们必须要明白的不同类型的活动。
There are vikarmic activities, which means acts which are against the teaching of the scriptures.
有 vikarmic 的活动，就意味着你活动的时候违背所有经典的叙事。
Vikarmic activities means doing things like meat eating, taking intoxication, gambling. These are all vikarmic activities.
Vikarmic 的活动就指的是，吃这些肉啊，还有服用麻醉品、赌博，这些全都属于 Vikarmic 的活动。
And karmic activities are acts performed in order to enjoy the result of the work.
而那个 karmic 就是那种 karmic 的活动，指的是你做一些活动为了享受这个世界。
People perform activities they want to.Maybe go to the higher planets to enjoy the sense gratification in the heavenly planets.
人们做一些活动，可能是因为他们想要到高等的星球去进一步的享受感官享乐。
Or they may just simply like to enjoy more sense gratification in this life.
或者呢，他们是想在此生之中得到更多的感官享乐。
To have more wealth, to have more fame or power.
有更多的财富，更多的名誉，更多的权利。
And people may perform pious activities which are recommended in the scriptures in order to get these material benefits.
人们可能会按照经典上的叙事做一些虔诚活动，但为的是得到这些物质的结果，物质的好处。
So that's karmic activities.
因此这便是 karmic 的活动。
The results may be good.But if you do the activity, if there's any mistake in the performance of the rituals, then you will get reactions.
结果可能是好的，但是如果你是为了物质的一个目的去履行这些仪式的话，你可能就会得到业报反应。
It's very easy to make a mistake in performing these kinds of activities.
在履行这种活动的过程之中，很容易犯错误。
The mantras can be wrongly chanted, and you can get the opposite meaning to what you wanted.
Mantra 可能会被唱错，然后你会得到你想要的相反的结果。
They have to be very careful in performing karmic activities.
所以应该非常的小心，你要在做 karmic 的活动的时候。
But there's another kind of activity, which is above karmic activities. It is called akarma.
但是还有另外的一种活动，这个超越 karmic 的活动，它被称为是 akarma。
akarma means there's no reaction to the work。
akarma 的意思就是做的活动没有任何的业报反应。
So akarmic activities means acts of devotional service。
因此 ，our karmic 的这个活动的意思就是在奉献服务之中去活动。
Acts of devotional service, particularly beginning with hearing and chanting.
实际上，奉献服务尤其是属于聆听和唱诵。
And also engaging in service for the pleasure of the Lord.
还有为了取悦主而从事于服务。
So devotees who offer all of the results of this work for the pleasure of the Lord.
因此，奉献者会为了取悦主而从事这些服务。
He considers the Lord to be the master, and he is the servant.
他会认为主是他的主人，而他自己是主的仆人。
And he has no desire to change that status of being the servant.
而且他没有任何的愿望想要去改变他作为仆人的地位。
In the material world, someone may be the servant, but he's simply desiring to become the controller.
在物质世界里，没有人想要当仆人，他只想要，他可能身份是仆人，但他的愿望是想要成为控制者。
But the actual proper mood of a devotee engaging in bhakti yoga in order to achieve a karma, to avoid any reactions, he has to perform the act in a manner which is pleasing to the Supreme Lord.
一个从事于奉献服务的奉献者。他做所有的一切，想要达到阿卡玛的这个境地，就必须是为了取悦主而做他所有的活动。
Only in this way can he enjoy transcendental happiness.
只有这样，他才可以享受到超然的快乐。
Transcendental happiness means a pleasure which is beyond the senses and even the mind.
超然的快乐就意味着超越感官，甚至是超越心意。
That kind of pleasure is experienced when we engage in the devotional activities.
这种快乐只有在我们去从事于奉献服务的活动之中才能得到。
It is the highest happiness.
这是最高的快乐。
Everyone wants happiness. We are trying to find happiness everywhere.
每个人都想得到快乐，我们试图在所有的地方找到快乐。
It's the nature of every living entity looking for enjoyment.
每一个生物体的本性都是去寻找享受。
It is the anandamaya vyasat. The nature of the soul is eternal happiness.
Anandamaya vyasat. 灵魂的本性就是寻找快乐。
We have to understand that what is real happiness.It is awakened by the devotional activities.
我们必须要知道，真正的快乐是由奉献服务的活动所唤起的。
And that pleasure which is achieved in devotional service is so great that one never wants any other kind of happiness.
而在奉献服务之中所得到的快乐是如此之巨大，以至于一个人再也不想要从其他的地方得到快乐。
The nature of material happiness is very temporary and very flickering. It does not last very long.
物质的这种感官享受的快乐，它的本性就是非常的短暂，而且转瞬即逝，不会持续很久。
Just like relationships sometimes between men and women.
就像有的时候在男人和女人之间的关系。
In the beginning, it can be so much pleasure.
在一开始的时候，会显得有很多快乐。
But it can change to poison.
但是可以变成毒药。
In Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes different kinds of happiness.
在巴格丽塔之中，主释迦描述了各种不同类型的快乐。
Happiness in the mode of passion. In the beginning, it is like nectar.But quickly it changes to something very unpleasant.
在激情属性之中的快乐，在一开始的时候显得好像甘露一样，但很快的它就会变成非常令人不快的东西。
And happiness in the mode of ignorance is simply suffering from beginning to end.
而处在愚昧属性之中的快乐，从始至终都是痛苦。
But people are so much in ignorance. They're thinking this is happiness.
可是人们处在如此的愚昧之中，以至于他们认为这就是快乐。
We see, for example, people taking drugs, drinking alcohol, they're thinking this is happiness.
我们看到有一些人，他们吸毒喝酒，认为这就是快乐。
But it's just suffering from beginning to end.
但是从始至终，这个都是痛苦。
And happiness in the mode of goodness, in the beginning, it is like poison.
而在善良属性之中的快乐，在一开始像毒药一样。
But gradually it becomes like nectar.
但逐渐的变得像甘露一样。
So we can experience this happiness in the mode of goodness, if you consider things like controlling the mind and senses.
我们在这种善良属性之中快乐，有时候我们就会想到控制自己的心意和感官。
Just like some people, they have a difficult time to control the tongue, to take up a vegetarian diet. For some people, it's very difficult.
就像有的人他们很难控制自己的舌头，变成一个素食者。有的人他在这方面就是极为困难。
But if they will tolerate, they will go on gradually.They learn to overcome the desire to eat all kinds of animal food and flesh, and they are happy with a vegetarian diet.
但是如果他们坚持不断地去忍受他们的这种想要吃动物的制品还有肉食的愿望，他们逐渐就可以控制住自己的感官，然后体验到快乐。
Similarly, in Krishna consciousness, we like to wake up earlier in the morning.
同样在科学的知觉之中，我们想早点起床。
We have a service here in the temple in the morning at 5:15.
我们五点一刻的时候在庙里就有服务。
We call it Mangal Arti. Mangal means auspicious.
我们管这个叫 Mangal Arti. Mangal 的意思就是吉祥的。
And it is said, if you come for Mangal Arti, your whole day will be auspicious.
就是说，如果你来参加 Mangal Arti， 那么整你的一天呢都非常的吉祥。
Of course, here in Malaysia, especially Kuala Lumpur, we call it the city which never sleeps.
当然了，在马来西亚，尤其是在这个吉隆坡，我们管这个城市叫不夜城。
You go out in the middle of the night, you see so many cars are on the road.
如果你在半夜的时候出去，你会看见路上全都是车。
Even restaurants are open all night. People go to restaurants and eat meals in the middle of the night.
甚至是餐厅整夜都开着门，有很多的人他们会半夜的时候去吃东西。
And when it comes to Mangal Arti, nobody is around.
等到了 Mangal Arti 的时间，周围就没人了。
That is a misfortune, right? That they're not able to come for the auspicious time.
这是他们的不幸，他们不能够在吉祥的时刻到来。
But in all spiritual practices, it is customary for people to take advantage of the auspicious time of the day.
但是在所有的灵性修行之中，大家的习惯都是要充分利用一天之中的吉祥时刻。
Before the sunrise, it is called Brahma Muhurta. It's about 1.5 hours before sunrise.
在太阳升起之前，这段时间被称为是 Brahma Muhurta， 大概时长一个半小时。
So that's why we have the service here at 5:15.
就是为什么我们在这儿有一个服务，就是从五点一刻开始。
Because by about 6:45, then the sun is coming up here in Malaysia.
因为大概提到6:45的时候，在马来西亚太阳就升起了。
If you go to India.In India, they have the Mangal Arti at 4:30 every morning.
如果你们去印度的话，在印度 Mangal Arti 每天早上是4:30。
Because the sunrise is 6:00 in the morning.
因为太阳在早上6:00的时候升起。
So the auspicious time of the day, the Brahma Muhurta, we like to take advantage of that time for spiritual practice.
因此，一天的这种吉祥时刻，那么不过的，我们将把它充分的利用起来，休息非常之觉。
But you know, ordinary common people are not accustomed to wake up at that time of the day. But if they, in the beginning, they may find it difficult to do that, but if they practice later on, it becomes very pleasing. It's a very pleasant time of the day. It's very peaceful and very suitable for spiritual practice. But common people are so absorbed in the mode of passion and ignorance, they cannot appreciate the mode of goodness. So we're seeing the mode of goodness. In the beginning, it's like poison, difficult, but if you keep trying, gradually it becomes very pleasing. And similarly with chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. But in the beginning it may be difficult to chant. You have no patience, you're not able to sit and chant much. Get some people to chant just one mantra. Sometimes that's a great achievement just to get them to chant one mantra. And then we ask them, go try to chant 8 mantras. And then a bit higher, go to 108 mantras. Oh, wonderful, you chanted one round.
Oh, 太棒了,你唱诵了一圈。
Now we want you to chant more rounds. So in the beginning, it's difficult, it's not so easy for people, ordinary people, to control the mind and to sit and chant. They can spend hours watching movies. They can go shopping for hours. But to ask them to chant the Hare Krishna mantra for a little while is very difficult. But if they can do it, then gradually they can taste the pleasure of the mode of goodness. They can come to the transcendental platform. Although they're engaged in many activities, they can be transcendental. We don't need to stop activities, we just have to change the quality of the activities. We have to do it for Krishna. That is the important quality. So maybe we will ask for some questions now. Yes. Rama Yagna, isn't it?
Yes, Maharaj. We heard that personally we are afraid of action because of fear of reaction. So I used to think when we interact with people, you know, we have a relationship with them, there is always some sort of karma involved. If we do devotional service for Krishna, does that mean like Krishna will always protect us and take away all those karmas?
Now speaking Chinese.
我的问题是，我们听到说非人道主义者他们的害怕活动是因为活动产生的结果或者说是反应。我以前会觉得，当我们和人打交道的时候，当我们建立关系，会有这种业力的一个会产生一些业力，所以我们为菩萨做外服务的话，菩萨就会把这些业力带走，或者说是会保护我们。
Yes, a devotee, we say a devotee is acting on the transcendental platform, so he's free from the reactions of karma.
是的，我说当出现者他在活动的时候呢，他处在超然的层面上，所以他就免于 karma 的业报反应。
But we have to understand there's a quality in acting in devotional sense.
但是我们要知道，在奉献服务之中去活动的时候，是有一种品质的。
That he has to actually perform the activity for the pleasure of Krishna.
他必须做这个活动的目的是为了取悦 Krishna。
His devotional service should be just like a blazing fire.
他的奉献服务就应该好比是熊熊大火。
The blazing fire can burn all the reactions to ashes.
熊熊大火可以把所有的业报反应烧成灰烬。
So the devotional service has to be of a particular quality.
所以奉献服务具备一定的品质。
It shouldn't be influenced by the past, by passion and ignorance.
不应该受到激情和愚昧的影响。
It should be performed simply for the pleasure of Krishna.
仅仅应该是为了取悦 Krishna 而进行。
And it should be pleasing to Krishna.
而且应该是取悦 Krishna 的。
It should be without material desire.
不应该有任何物质的愿望。
That is Krishna consciousness.
那便是 Krishna 知觉。
So if we act like that, then there's no reactions.
如果我们这样行动的话，就不会有任何的反应。
But to come to that platform of devotional service, we have to practice.
但为了达到这种奉献服务的层面，我们必须要修习。
We have to come to the higher level of Krishna consciousness.
我们必须要达到 Krishna 知觉的更高层面。
We are trying to become Vaishnava.
我们在努力地成为 Vaishnava.
We are practicing. We're still practicing, but to come to that level will take some time.
我们在修习，但是我们想达到那个层面是需要花一定的时间的。
But if we have that sincere desire to just want to please Krishna, then certainly there will be no reaction.
但如果我们愿望诚恳，只想取悦 Krishna， 那么肯定的不会有任何的反应。
So it's quality in our service.
所以在服务之中，在我们的服务之中是有品质的。
It's not just they do the service, but there must be that quality, the mood of wanting to actually please Krishna.
就是说，我们做服务都是有一个品质，我们应该做服务的时候有一种想要取悦 Krishna 的情感。
Right, we talk about not only service but devotional service.
我们不仅仅谈论服务，我们谈论的是奉献服务。
We're performing the activity for the pleasure of Krishna with devotion.
我们做活动的时候是为了取悦 Krishna， 满怀奉爱的去做。
One time, the devotees were making garlands for the deities. They had no flowers, and they got some, they got some old flowers which are all withered and faded. And when Prabhupada saw the deities with all of these old flowers, he was very upset, and he said to the devotees, "They do have no bow."
有一次，有一个奉献者，他专门为神像做花环，可是他却没有花，所以他就找了一些特别老的花，都要凋谢了、蔫了的花。 当说话巴德看到神像带着这种话的时候呢，他非常的不高兴，说你根本就没有妈妈。
So we have to have that bhava, that mood to want to serve Krishna, to please Krishna. And then there will be no reactions. Krishna will protect us from any reaction. Yes.
Thank you, Maharaj. Maharaj, I think said that the China group will be leaving next week, and this meeting of Hawaii and New Venus is running upon me. So, the question is, how do we keep ourselves motivated in the absence, in our heart towards greater devotional service. Thank you.
You want to speak in Chinese?
Sorry, Maharaj, I can't speak Chinese. No.
Thank you, Maharaj. I'm not able to listen to you. I'm not able to listen to you. I'm not able to listen to you.
他说下周他说这是奉献者就回去就走了，他就感觉到非常的孤独，然后他就想着怎么样才能够激励自己，然后做更好的奉献服务。
Yes, you have to take shelter of Srila Prabhupada.
你必须要脱离Srila Prabhupada。
Srila Prabhupada is there.
Srila Prabhupada在那。
And Lord Jagannath is here.
Jagannath,
so you take shelter of the deities and Srila Prabhupada, and you take shelter of Srila Prabhupada's books. And the holy name. And there's always some devotees here. Not all the devotees are going.
还有一些奉献者留在这儿，不是说所有的奉献者都走了。
The devotees were talking today. They said there's so many Chinese people here in Malaysia.
今天呢，奉献者跟我说，在马来西亚其实有很多华人。
So you have to bring more Chinese people.
那你就带更多的华人来。
So they're going. You have to get more.
他们走了，你带更多的人来。
There's so many Chinese people around here.
在这个周围有很多的华人。
One devotee was saying, Jyoti Gopinath was saying that where she went to someone's house yesterday, the whole building was full of Chinese people.
Jyoti Gopinath 说昨天他住在别人家里，整个这栋楼全都是中国人。
So there's a lot of people, and there's so many old people from China studying here in Malaysia. You can go and preach to them. Yashoda Devi was saying today about different programs which the Chinese people have, like Wushu and different activities.We should go there and distribute books and go there and preach to the people. Go and introduce Krishna consciousness to them. There's so much to be done. Don't just sit and lament.
不要仅仅是坐在那里悲伤。
I have to become active. They have come to inspire you. Now they have to go back to their place.
你要活跃起来，他们来激励了你，现在他们要回到自己的地方。
They're all from different places in China.
他们都来自于不同的地方，中国不同的地方。
They're going to go, they have to go back, and there's so many people there, they have to encourage them.
他们要回去，然后当地还有很多人，他们要去鼓励他们。
So, you are here, you have to take care of this place.
你在这儿，你要照顾好这个地方。
Don't find these people, find the Chinese people and give Krishna consciousness.
然后呢，你要去找到更多的其他的华人，给他们 Krishna 拒绝。
There's a lot of preaching to be done.
有很多的这个传播的工作来做。
We have so many books. You take some books, you go. Prabhupada said you can just go with cartels, take Madanga and cartel. You go yourself. And somebody will come along and they can play the Madanga or they'll play the cartels. You can have kirtan. More people will come and join.
然后你应该去出去派车，出去传播。你可以画画的时候，你可以带着你刚刚鼓，带着挠钹。然后呢，一开始这样的，一开始就会有人来加入你。然后你打着你刚刚鼓，打着挠钹，会更多的人来加入你。
You just have to have that enthusiasm. That's the most important quality.
你只需要有热情，这是最重要的品质。
Patience.It's a little okay, patient. You don't want to be too patient.
耐心，就还凑合吧。我们也不想说太耐心了。
We may say, oh well, well, I wait till next year when Chinese people come back again next year.
然后你就说，我就等着吧，等着下一年，明年中国复兴的再来。
No, you can't wait that long.
不，你不要等那么久。
You have to be enthusiastic.
你必须要有热情。
Devotees of Krishna are everywhere. They're just waiting for us to go there and find them.
Krishna 的奉献者无处不在，就等着我们出去找到他们。
Just have that enthusiasm. You'll be surprised how many people are waiting to become Krishna conscious.
你必须要具备这样的热情，然后你会非常的惊讶，发现多少人都等着要有 Krishna 知觉。
I was in the Middle East and there was one lady, she was living in a big building.
我在中东有一位女士住在一栋大楼里。
And she put an ad on the internet saying, you know, anybody interested in Bhagavad Gita, I'm going to start a class. And she got so many people, and people were even living in the same building where she was living, and they came for her class.
他在这个互联网上发布了一条消息，说谁有兴趣就可以来，我要讲巴洛皮特的课程。结果来了好多的人，甚至还有来自于跟他住同一个大楼的人。
So, you know, you just have to have that little bit enthusiasm and a little bit bold, and Krishna will send people to help you.
然后呢，你就必须要有这种热情。而且你要充满一些希望，可是就会来帮助你，他就会派人来找你。
Prabhupada went there with nothing, with no one, but Krishna sent people to help him.
帕帕德去那儿的时候呢，没有人，而且他也没有钱，但是 Krishna 派人来加入他，帮助他。
So certainly it can happen.
肯定会发生。
You just an instrument in the service of Krishna.
你只不过是在服务 Krishna 过程之中的一个工具。
So just go out there in the battlefield.
出去上战场。
And you'll find people are ready, waiting to become Krishna conscious.
你会发现人们在等待，人们已经准备好了要变得具有 Krishna 知觉。
You may find it easier to mix with people who are maybe not so much coming to temple in the beginning, but you can have some other place where you can meet people.
可能你会遇到一些人，他并不会特别感兴趣，就都来庙里。你可以另外的一个地方去见他。
One devotee told me he's preaching in America. He said the temples in America today, many Indian people are there.
有一个奉献者跟我说，在美国现在庙里呢有很多印度人。
So the American people, they're not so much attracted to go there.
然后美国人就不太受吸引去那儿。
And so they made a separate place.
于是他做了一个单独的地方。
And they have the Westerner people come there to another place and they cultivate them. And once they're a little stronger in Krishna consciousness, then later they bring them to temple.
他就在这个单独的地方培养只有西方人，然后等到他们成熟了，然后变得更加坚定的时候，他就会带他们去庙。
In New Zealand, they have a program in Auckland, in New Zealand, they have a program called The Loft. And they don't bring people, they have a big temple in Auckland, but they don't bring people immediately to the temple. Instead, they bring them to the loft.
在新西兰的奥克兰，他们开始了一个节目，就是虽然他们这个新西兰的奥克兰有庙，但他们不会把新人马上带到庙里，他们就把大家带到一个月子，一个宫里，所以他们的这个节目的名字就叫做 Loft， 就是一个宫里，就是月子的这个意思。
And they will have special prasadam. They will have nice, very healthy, nutritious wholemeal bread, and you know, and very fresh salad.
他们会安排非常营养可口的 prasadam， 比如说他们会做全麦的面包，还有非常新鲜的、非常好吃的沙拉。
And health food, you know, to attract the, you know, the modern age people.
健康食品就是为了吸引那些现代的人们。
And then, and gradually they introduce them to the Krishna conscious lifestyle.
逐渐的，他们在吸引他们越来越深入 Krishna 知觉。
After association with people at the loft, after hearing some basic teachings about the soul and the difference between the body and the soul and controlling the mind and senses.And introducing them to chanting, then they bring them to temple.
先在这个宫里里边给他们讲一些最基本的知识，比如说什么是灵魂，灵魂跟躯体之间的区别，还有对心意和感官的控制。再介绍他们做一点点的唱诵，之后呢，再把他们带到庙里去。
You see, in Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami speaking to Maharaj Pariksit.He doesn't begin by immediately talking about devotional service.
我们可以看到，在释迦牟尼佛当中，释迦牟尼佛并没有立刻给 Krishna 来讲奉献服务。
He talks about the universal form and contemplating the universe as a form of God.
他先讲的是宇宙形体，就是把宇宙形体当中主的一个样子的一个展示来进行冥想。
And then he goes on and talks about the super soul, seeing the understanding the Lord in the heart of everyone.
接着他开始谈到了超灵，也就是说去冥想，去看到在每个人的内心之中的主。
And then he comes after that, then he will speak about Bhagavan, devotional service.
然后只有在这之后，他才谈到 Bhagavan 奉献服务。
But the main thing is to be friendly, to go out there and make friends.
但主要的呢是要非常的友好，出去跟别人交朋友。
There's a lot of lonely people around.
在周围其实有很多孤独的人。
And they're looking for company. They want some company.
他们寻找着别人的陪伴，他们需要有一些人陪着他们。
They want to find some nice people.
他们想找到一些很好的人。
Not people are going to cheat them and rob them and deceive them.
不是那些能够欺骗他们，然后去掠夺他们，去剥削他们的人。
So if you can make some really good friendship with people, that can help to bring people to Krishna consciousness.
如果你能够跟其他的人建立很好的友谊，这也可以帮助他们，让他们进入 Krishna 知觉。
Okay, Pandu. Hare Krishna. Okay, any other question?
还有其他的问题吗？
Hare Krishna, may I ask, for working devotee who work outside, because we need to earn a living, so earn a living so that we can have accommodation for ourselves, to get out on health, and also for transportation, but we donate a certain percentage to devotional, to the temple, but is that then,that work outside, is it considered also devotional service ahana? Or because we still need to work and support ourselves?
他的问题是他在外面要上班要工作要家糊口还要挣钱，然后呢但是他会拿一部分钱出来捐给庙里，所以在这种情况之下他去上的那个班算是阿卡尔玛吗？
Yes, if you're doing it in consciousness that I'm working for Krishna.
是的，如果你要是做这个工作的时候你的知觉想的是我为 Krishna 而工作。
Right, you should start your day with some chanting.
你在这一天刚开始的时候以唱诵开始。
And you should do some chanting before you go to work.
你在上班之前应该先念诵。
You should be thinking of Krishna.
应该想着 Krishna.
At some point you should hear some kirtans.
你应该聆听一些 kirtan.
Just like when you drive your car, you can be hearing kirtan or you can be hearing a lecture by Prabhupada.
就像你在开车的时候可以听 Kirtan 或者是 Prabhupada 讲课。
You don't want to be just talking.
你并不想就总是说话就聊天。
Or, you know, mobile phone and talking to people.
总是拿着手机跟别人讲话。
But you should be thinking, trying to think of Prabhupada and Krishna and taking time to hear.
你应该努力地想着花不花 Krishna 花时间去聆听。
You want to do your work in Krishna consciousness.
你想在 Krishna 知觉之中去做你的工作。
So you have to do sadhana.
所以你要做 sadhana.
You have to have practice every day.
你必须要
chant the holy name.
每天去休息唱诵圣名。
And if you're working like that for Krishna, then there's no karma.
如果你这样为 Krishna 而工作的话，那就没有 karma.
But if you're working just thinking, I'll get rich, I'll make a lot of money, I'll get a bigger house, I'll live in luxury, then that's not good.
但如果你总是想着我上班，我就可以买一所大房子，我可以挣很多的钱，我可以过上很奢侈的生活，那就不好了。
I will get a better, faster car.
我会再买一辆更好的、更快的车。
You will get one of the tell the new.
卡迪拉克。
These more the electronic cars.
有那很多电子设备的车。
Full of microchips.
里面充满了内存芯片。
One man told me, he said, if you have a Volvo car, he said, you take it to the garage, and the garage goes, connects the car to the computer, and they go to Sweden, and the factory in Sweden will repair the car anywhere in the world.
然后呢，人们说，如果你买一辆沃尔沃的汽车，然后把这个车开到修理厂去，他们就会把这个汽车连上电脑。然后这个电脑就把数据传送到在瑞典的汽车总部，他们在瑞典就可以修理全世界各地的这种沃尔沃的汽车。
So you know, you can repair the car without even getting your hands dirty.
所以你连手都不脏就可以修车了。
You just sit on the computer.
你就坐在电脑面前。
And it's all done by computer.
然后所有的一切由电脑来完成。
So people think, oh, I have to have a car like that, you know.
人就想着，哎呦，我得只赶紧的弄一辆那样的车。
Work very hard, make a lot of money.
非常辛苦的工作，赚很多的钱。
And completely forget Krishna.
完全忘记了 Krishna.
So that's very dangerous.
那是非常危险的。
You have to try to become. You have to think how to remember Krishna.
应该想着怎么去记住 Krishna.
And if we are sincere, Krishna will help us. Krishna is in our heart, and he will instruct us how we can think more of Krishna.
Krishna, 其实如果你很诚恳 ，Krishna 就会从你的内心之中教导你，然后告诉你什么样的方法，你可以更多的意念 Krishna.
Tesham satata yodhanam vajatam priti kurvatam dadami buddhi yogam tam yenamam upayantite. To those who are constantly devoted to me, and worship me with love, I give the understanding by which they can come to me.
那些不断的以父爱之心来服务我，并且努力崇拜我的人，我就会赐予他们理解力，以使他们能够来到我跟前。
So, that's the secret.
这就是秘密。
Be devoted to Krishna, and then no karma.
成为 Krishna 的奉献者就没有 karma。
Even though you're working, going to office.
尽管你在上班，你要去办公室。
Or working in the factory.
或者在工厂里工作。
But if you're giving some good portion of your income to Krishna, then you'll be protected.
但如果你把你的工资的很好的一部分给 Krishna 的话，你就会受到保护。
You want to make advancement? Put your money in that box.
你想取得进步吗？就把你的钱放在那个箱子里。
So.Yes, no karma.
是的，没有 karma.
You're in the renounced order of life.
你就处在了生命的弃绝阶段。
Because you're working for Krishna.
因为你在为 Krishna 而工作。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, thank you very much. Shri Prabhupada ki.